Welcome to the Efficient eLearning SAP Training Series. This video is SAP Accounts Payable, Transaction FB08, Reverse Document. And here's the topics we'll be covering. First up, we'll confirm where transaction code FB08 fits in the Procure-to-Pay process. We'll then review the scenarios where a document requires reversal. In order to manufacture a reversal scenario, we'll post a duplicate non-PO invoice using transaction FB60. Once the duplicate invoice is posted, we'll then analyse the vendor line item display, transaction FBL1N. The final step is reversing the duplicate invoice using transaction FB08. The vendor line item display can then be refreshed to demonstrate the impact of the reversal. Let's begin with where transaction FB08 fits in the Procure-to-Pay process. Transaction FB08 is used to reverse non-PO invoices and credit memos, that is, invoices and credit memos that do not reference a purchase order. Consequently, the procurement steps in the Procure-to-Pay process, create purchase requisition, approve purchase requisition, convert requisition to purchase order, and post goods receipt are not relevant. Transaction FB08 sits within the post vendor invoice step and is completed by the accounts payable department. Okay, so we've established where transaction FB08 fits in the procure-to-pay process. Let's now discuss the scenarios where a document requires reversal. The most common usage of transaction FB08 is reversing non-PO invoices and credit memos, and these are the main scenarios. Duplicate documents, for example, the same invoice has been posted twice. Documents posted to the wrong vendor code. Documents posted against the wrong company code. And any other documents posted with other incorrect details that cannot be changed on a posted document. In this video, we'll post a duplicate non-PO invoice and then use transaction FB08 to reverse the document. Let's now post a duplicate non-PO invoice in transaction FB60. On the left of screen is the original non-PO invoice we posted in a previous video for transaction FB60, post vendor invoice. On the right of screen is transaction FB60, pre-populated with the same invoice details, with one exception. I've added an extra zero to the invoice number to allow the invoice to be incorrectly posted a second time. As the balance of the invoice is zero, and there are no error messages displayed, we can now click the Post button to post the vendor invoice. Note the internal SAP document number for the invoice at the bottom of the screen. Now the invoice has been posted, we can view it on the vendor line item display, transaction FBL1N. Double-click on the FBL1N favorite to open the transaction. Some values have defaulted into the vendor account and company code fields. I know the company code, so that's definitely correct. However, I don't know the vendor code, so I'll search for it just to be sure. Click the drop-down list to the right of the vendor field, click in the name field, and type XYZ asterisk, then click the Start Search button. Double-click on the desired entry. We can now choose a line item selection. There are three choices: open items, cleared items, and all items. I'd like to see both open items and cleared items, so I'll choose All Items. Now we move down to the Type section. Both invoices and credit memos are normal items, which is the default selection, so I'll leave this section as it is. I can now click the Execute button to run the report. This is the original invoice, and this is the duplicate we just processed. Double-click on the duplicate entry and click the Call-up Document Overview button. Note the following field values: document number, company code, and fiscal year. We will need these three values when posting the reversal in transaction FB08. Now click the green back arrow to return to the vendor line item display. We'll leave this screen open in SAP so that once we've completed the document reversal in transaction FB08, we can return to the report and refresh the list to see the impact of the reversal. If you're new to SAP, it's worth noting where transaction FB08 resides in the SAP standard menu. Start with the accounting folder. Then financial accounting, accounts payable, document, and reverse. Now you can simply double-click on this entry to open the transaction. However, as I'll be using this transaction code frequently, I'll create a favorite for the transaction. I'll click and drag the transaction and release the mouse button on top of the FB65 favorite. This will insert the favorite below FB65. I'm not happy with the standard description, so I'll right-click on the entry and choose Change Favorite. I'll rename the entry Reverse Non-PO Document and click Continue. I can now double-click on this favorite to open the transaction. Click in the Document Number field. Enter the document number of the duplicate non-PO invoice posted earlier and ensure the company code and fiscal year fields are populated correctly. Click in the Reversal Reason field and click the drop-down list to the right of the field. As our duplicate invoice was posted in the current period, we'll choose Reason 01, Reversal in Current Period. Double-click on the entry to select it. It's always a good idea to display the document before reversal, just to make sure you are reversing the correct document. Click the Display Before Reversal button to display the document. Once you are satisfied it's the correct document, click the green back arrow to return to the previous screen. You can now click the Post button to post the reversal document. Note the internal SAP document number for the reversal document at the bottom of the screen. We can now return to the vendor line item display, transaction FBL1N, and refresh the list. However, before we refresh the list, pay particular attention to the duplicate invoice. It's currently an open item, but when we refresh the list, you'll see that it then becomes a cleared item. So let's refresh the list now. Choose Menu option, List, Refresh. So this is the duplicate invoice document. You'll note the status has changed from an open item to a cleared item. And this is the reversal document. If you look at the clearing document column, you can see that both items are cleared by the reversal document. Consequently, both the duplicate invoice and the reversal document will not be picked up in the payment run and will not appear on the vendor remittance advice that is sent to the vendor. That's everything covered for this video. Remember to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to be notified when new videos are uploaded. Thanks for watching.